be a short meeting. We're going down the agenda, we've got minutes from May the 8th. Let's go to that.
Do we need to appoint anybody for anybody?
Oh, let's see. David's here, Graham's here, I'm here, you're here.
Yeah, I figured it out, but.
He was a member, right? Are you an alternate or a member?
Alternate.
So we're missing Jamie. So you get to be Jamie. And this is somebody else, right?
Karen's usually.
Josh.
Josh.
You're Josh.
Okay.
Thank you. So you think on May the 8th, that requires correction or anything of that nature? Your silence is definite.
Motion, thanks, sir.
Thank you. There a second?
I'll second it.
Graham? Any discussion? This was the big one, of course, where we talked about the money. All those in favor of approving the minutes of May the 8th, please by saying aye.
Aye.
And then we have a very, very, very short meeting on May the 14th, where we'll set the no rate. How many of you approve that one? How many here? For a second? Keith?
I'll second that.
Thank you. All those in favor, please by saying aye.
Aye.
Seems the deed was done, I know the bills have gone out, everything's based on it, right? I'm not aware of any correspondence, did you see any correspondence?
Yes, there is.
Maybe something from Alan, of course.
Thank you. We have a refund due to a taxpayer $95.24 that Eleanor would like us to approve doing because it's an excess payment. I'll move that. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, David. Discussion? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
I love the system. Which is which here?
New and old.
Look at all these 100%. What a surprise.
That must be the new one.
That wouldn't be good, would it? So, don't look too bad. How did we do?
We ended in the black. Bottom line.
Good. By a whole lot or just some?
90-some-odd thousand.
That's about what I just saw. So, anything on the current, how many days into the current budget? 10 days?
Yeah,
I think we'll let that pass.
Yeah, I think the only department that was over was public safety, and you can almost attribute that down to exactly the money spent in repairing the garage at the ambulance building. And you're quoting that for about 9,000 euros, but that was the only department that was spent. The only full department that was spent.
That's good. Anything else in the selectmen's report besides that? Anything going on in burning issues? Any big grants?
Well, we have two grants, and I'm moaning and groaning, and I said I would never do another one, and I'm sitting here contemplating going for both of them. One, I'm thinking of doing the sidewalks with, so to get those done all at once rather than piecemeal. I have to go to, that's an economic one, and I have to go to a meeting on that one. That's a new one that came out. The steep grant, there's a couple of caveats to the steep grant. And I thought about applying for it for the fire department, but if you're going to do a big capital project like that, you've got to have your funding in place, and you have to prove that you've got your funding in place. I think what they've run into in the past is too many towns when they've gotten into asking for the $500,000. Don't spend it for 3 or 4 years.
It just sits there.
And it just sits there. So I think what they're looking for is making sure that you've got all your eggs in a basket, your ducks in a row before, but I'm still thinking about that. So I'm not sure where, what we'll do with that. So those are the two grants. They're both $500,000 grants.
But nothing else going on?
The development program is finished.
When is the next school consolidation?
That hasn't been decided yet.
I think so.
No.
You know, since our last meeting, that group met once again. It was a pretty good meeting too, but it was kind of scary because some of the things that are going to happen in towns like Norfolk over the next 5 to 10 years in terms of our ECS grants look pretty grim. I think what Sue, we're going to probably end up 50% of what we get now.
Probably, yeah, half. From 380 to 190, yeah.
Not going to do it all at once, but they're going to do it, and we're going to have to take that into consideration when the day comes, which isn't today. The next meeting of that group is going to review.
Sometime towards the end of this month, beginning of August.
But it's moving along.
Mm-hmm. You got the notification about the hotel teachers negotiations?
Oh, shoot. I was supposed to bring that.
I got it.
The superintendent would like to know what we think is the proper term for the collective bargaining agreement that's going to be negotiated, I guess, next month, isn't it?
They start next month. There's a public meeting. You might not have gotten the information. I think it's on the 23rd. I can email Holly.
We had an interesting experience.
4:30.
The thunderstorm 2 weeks ago Monday.
Yeah.
Zapped us. And we didn't know it, so we hadn't had the internet for 2 weeks. Very quiet.
You didn't notice?
I don't turn it on every day.
Every 2 weeks?
When I need to. But
other people in the office must have realized.
No, no, at home.
This oh, at home. Oh.
Oh, it worked.
Oh, it would have been instantaneous.
much as I used to despise it, it's rather useful to get in touch with people who aren't there. Mm. But the Board of Ed, I guess, is what would like to know what do we think would be the proper length of time for a collective bargaining agreement. And your choices, I think, are 1, 2, or 3 years. I don't think there's any have ever been longer than 3 years that I can
tell. No, I can't think of anything.
And some have been shorter than that. They're an extension now, frankly, mm-hmm. on a 3-year program. Anybody got any opinions on it? My opinion was 2 years. Because I think in 2 years, if we're going to do something with the school systems, we're going to do it. Particularly if the governor's going to start cutting our funding.
But even if they do something with the school systems, no matter what the length of the contract, wouldn't you have to do something because Colebrook's contracts are somewhat different than Norfolk's contracts?
I don't know anything about their contract except I'm told that they're on the same schedule we are.
Right, they're on the same schedule, but there was a website that was comparing teacher contracts throughout the state.
Yeah.
And Colebrook's was somewhat different than Norfolk's as far as sick days, as far as paid leaves, things like that.
That's going to be...
So I would assume that both contracts would have to be renegotiated regardless.
Could be. But if you're, if you're in the middle of one, it's a lot harder to do than if you're at the end of one.
Yeah.
But you're right. As best I can tell, the big issue is going to be union contracts.
I mean, wouldn't the two entities actually cease to exist because a new entity is
taking
over? No. Not necessarily. Not necessarily.
No. Maybe.
You would think in the real world it would.
One of the...
In the real world, nobody has contracts.
One of the big issues that we're just going to have to wrestle with, and it's going to end up being in the town meeting, is going to be the old guard against the people who have a different opinion. Do you form an entity like we have for regional, so that you really have
a regionalization
as opposed to a collaborative or a cooperative or just
even a cooperative. Isn't that a new?
We had this great meeting with Tom Mooney, and he said, quoted us this statute and said, go read it, and you can do almost anything you want. Some of the problems in doing it that way, if you just have a, you know, contractual agreement with the town of Colebrook, is it's going to have a finite life, and then what do you do, and that kind of thing. Mm. And I think that what we're going to have presented eventually will be the pros and cons of doing it each of the different ways.
That's what was asked.
Yeah, and I don't know enough about it to go beyond that, but I want to be sure you stay up to date on the fact that these things are going on, and it's going to have a budgetary impact on us, we hope positive, and there are these forces on the outside that are going to definitely have an impact upon us, so I don't want you taken by surprise at some point.
Back to your original question, though. Isn't a lot of that dependent on what the school union wants to do as far as length of contract goes?
Sure. That's what our collective bargaining is all about. I want 1 year, you want 3 years.
You and I have both sat through these, and you know, the collective bargaining is in parentheses.
When you have such a small bargaining unit, you know, it's kind of weird, and all the people there are your neighbors and your friends.
I mean, two years makes sense based on what's going on.
It's all fun. while we're at it, does anybody want to be the Board of Finance participant besides me?
You're so good at it.
You don't get to do anything. You know, except you sit there and you glower.
We do that.
I do that pretty well.
I can't think of somebody better.
And do this. So I want to be sure that this board is kept up to date on these developments, because it's going to be a topic of conversation, and it's going to have, you know, financial impacts for us. And so that's why we wanted to put that. How are things in the Treasury Department 10 days into the fiscal year?
This report is the end of the year.
Yeah.
It's really a very beautiful report.
what percentage?
Which you don't have a copy of.
Right there.
But when you look down at the totals on the end, on your percentage of budget, we are very close to reflecting most everything. And I was telling Sue, we do not have town clerk's June figures, but it didn't matter because she still collected 176.6% without including anything from June.
Jesse, where's the bottom line?
Well, the last.
You have to add it all together. There's no button up
there. Well, then let me ask this. Next time we do this, can we have a bottom line?
Yeah. Yep.
Because you need to be able to go to one point and say, oh, we collected 99.8% of everything we were doing.
Right. Mm. Well, I also want to just point out, too, like on your planning and zoning, Mike Halloran, we expected him to collect $2,500. He collected $8,510, so he was at 340%.
Well, that's basically, you know, it's unfair to do that because that's just at the whim and whimsy of what's going to happen.
Well, right.
You
well,
know,
we
that's
are
what
over
it's not because Mike Heller went out and beat the bushes and got a bunch of contracts.
Yeah. I mean, it's just, it's at the whim and whimsy of what is going on. I have to tell you the truth, the building inspector.
He's over too. Yale.
But the only reason he's over is because he got Yale. Yeah. He was very. If Yale hadn't come through with that copper roof, I think we wouldn't. Just probably making what we anticipated.
And in the scheme of things, to be $22,790 over budget is kind of hoop to do.
Yeah, kind of. I collected $94,000 from FEMA.
It's better. It's better than it's
better than mine. I collected $94,000.
I suppose in one sense it does reflect activity, economic activity, mm-hmm. people doing renovations and things like that. That's okay. But
it's
someplace we ought to have a sort of bottom line mm-hmm. at the end of the year.
I'll do it according to
tax
the,
collection.
I'll do it according to the budget income. What was income and what we actually collected.
Yeah. I think that's sort of what this is.
It is, but at least it'll put it in the format that you're familiar with.
Because one of these days, I want to get away from this and have one instead of two. But
I don't know how you're going to do that.
To quote Lord of the Rings, but not this day.
Well, you can probably mix and match in a cloud of priests and create your own software.
But it's nice that, you know.
I like that approach.
I took a look too at recreation, and even though it was down this year, which again probably reflects the amount of kids in the school system, that we haven't collected as much as we expected to.
What in the world is top page?
On the bottom of page two, under recreation, we've got Toby Pond. Baseball, soccer, softball.
And we never collect.
What is the veterans grant?
That's, there is a couple of programs with the state. There's a program if you're a veteran where you get the $1,000, and if you're in, and then there's another program where you can get additional money, plus there's the town program, but this state program is the the veteran. Where do you see the veterans program?
On the first page, are there other state income? I don't remember ever seeing that in anything.
Elderly and tax relief?
No.
Where's the veteran grant?
Oh, two-thirds down.
Two-thirds away down.
Department of Energy and Environmental whatever grant. And the next one is Veterans with an interesting spelling grant.
Under other state income?
Page one.
Yeah, page one, about two-thirds down. $393.17.
You're on the first page.
Yeah.
What
the heck is that? Does anybody know?
It's like a vote, yeah.
There was a very interesting thing on.
I have no idea.
Veterans, as I was coming out.
I have no idea. The veterans, the only veterans information I know of has to come out of the assessor's office, and it seemed to me to be more than $393.
Yeah. Because we get $1,000 off our taxes, right?
Right, and then there's another assessment for those who qualify. I mean, I think that would go into the elderly and property tax relief line, but I'm not sure what that veterans grant is.
I'm just
now the
curious.
Department of Energy, that's the collection we got in the EECBG money.
The reason I'm asking is I'd like to know where $393.17 goes. Doesn't do much for a veteran.
I have no idea. Huh. You'd have to, Chelsea, you'd have to look it up.
Is this the news this afternoon? They've opened a veterans place in Jewett City where they rehabbed the American Legion. There's 16 units for homeless veterans. And they should say real crime for veterans. Anyway, I'm kind of curious about that, Chelsea. Would you see if you can find out?
Mm-hmm.
Peddler permits?
I'm sorry, what?
Peddler?
Yes, peddler permits. $25.
How many peddlers? We have one peddler?
Yep.
Yep.
Or two.
Oh,
that's
a sketch.
We have twice as many dogs as we thought we were going to have. More than twice as many dogs.
You tell me.
Dogs are actually this year we have more dogs than we ever had, but we usually don't have a great deal. I sometimes only get paperwork for 2 dogs a year.
Gun permits are up.
I talked to a friend in the cloud, she's getting a gun permit.
That's
what we're saying, get smarts.
This has nothing to do with.
She didn't mean the two-letter gun. All right. That's
and again, the dog licenses, just so you know, town clerk, again, will give me those figures for the new year.
Which will only improve our situation. Let's talk about the pension for a minute.
All right.
Have you finally been able to narrow it down soon?
No.
Well, golly darn heck.
I have been. I did talk to Union Savings Bank, which took over Litchfield. And they came and we sat and had a great discussion regarding it. And Karen couldn't attend that meeting, but I talked to her afterwards. And it appears that Union is now in the process of putting together figures, et cetera. They can probably take care of the whole thing. Now, I did get, we finally got Jeff Poland, which is Pension Services, to get back to us. And they're waiting for the 6/30/12, which just, Union Savings just sent out, which will then, he will, the end of the fiscal year, stock report, of which he will create the actuarial, what will be the unfunded balance at that point in time.
Okay.
I guess we're still going to the defined benefit.
Yes, yes.
Right, this isn't defined contribution plan.
No, this is, the defined contribution plan will not, probably not be started until January. And that being, because we already, we made their contribution for 2012 last year. So we really don't need another contribution until 2013.
Okay. Well, thank you for staying on their case.
Oh yeah, we're staying on their case.
You guys, you pay attention to the news, right?
Mm-hmm.
Stockton, California's filed bankruptcy.
Mm-hmm.
Among other reasons, because they have a huge unfunded pension liability. We're nothing like Stockton, California, but we put a ton of money in the budget this year, and I don't want to do that again, particularly if we're going to lose 5% on the education deal. So I think we're in pretty good shape. But we're always going to be subject to the market,
but the other, they even talked about the defined contribution, plan as to, and that's just...
Still a work in process.
A work in process, right.
If we convert all the defined benefit plans to annuities, however, we will not be subject to the market. It will be bought and fixed.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But as Karen was saying, say we're, unfunded, or we're funded up to, say we get ourselves funded up and that figure's 1.5. We still might have to collect another couple hundred thousand or whatever, or we might have to make it 2 million in order to sell it out as an annuity. That's
an
example. That was a question I asked as to how we could do this, and I have to say that I was very impressed with the gentleman I spoke to. From Union Savings Bank.
Good.
So it was.
It's a wonderful benefit of your years and years in the business. You bring some stuff to this that not many of the selectmen do that. So good. It's going to be on our agenda every month.
Whether you'll get an answer every month, I can't tell you.
But I don't want to lose sight of it. Anybody's watching this at home, I want them to know that it's something that is you're mindful of. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Anything in the EMS building?
We're still hashing it out.
Good. Next on the agenda is a 2/3 vote. Anybody got anything you want to put on for 2/3? Pray for rain, something like that. Public comment, Phyllis?
No, sir.
All right. Anybody else got anything to talk about? Probably won't need to have a meeting in August. It's, the dog days of August and nothing much happens. It would be nice if it rained every now and then. But other than that, I think we're okay. But I'll let you know in plenty of time if we do need to have a meeting. We'll plan on not having a meeting, if that makes sense. Is that a double negative? I don't think we're going to be in August, okay?
Yeah, 14th wouldn't work anyway.
Because what are we doing?
I think that's the primary that day.
It is the primary.
Yeah.
Oh.
So if you wanted to have to watch your pocket.
So if you can just say if you're going to meet, you will have a special meeting. Yeah. That would be
time.
The only reason you'd have to meet then, really.
You still have time to register as Republican so you can vote against somebody. There being no further business, certainly would entertain a motion to adjourn this here meeting.
Well,
David, thank you. Thank you so much. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you all for coming out.